definitely really motivating.
You're one of the hardest workers in boxing. I'm going to share a story if that's okay with you.
Yeah.
So I tell Mike Tyson, hey, I got to bring David Benavidez. We got to put him on the podcast. He goes, I love David. Mm-hmm. So I call you and I said, David, you want to come on the podcast? Well, Tuesday. You're like, nah, I'm busy this week. Call me next week on Tuesday. Most people would say we're going now. But yeah, you're like, you were in camp and that was your priority.
I think I was in Big Bear. Yeah, so Big Bear, I think, and did we go come down the mountain?
Yes.
Yeah, so, you know, sometimes you can't just do, you know, get off the schedule, you know, but I'm really happy that Mike waited for me because he could send me after
that. Nah, he wouldn't do that. He's, yeah. He loves you, and he gave you a nickname. I don't think he's given any other fighter a nickname.
Yeah, yeah, so it's just, like I said, it's really motivating, and, you know, I love Mike Tyson, and he's really happy with all the support I get from him.
I saw a quote where he was talking about you and Canelo. Did you happen to see it?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
I think it's 100% true. I mean,
what did he say?
Like I just said about honor right now. Canelo, he's showing that he doesn't really have no honor. And he doesn't care about the people. And he doesn't care about making the best fights happen. Honestly, at the end of the day, that's a spit in the face to his own fans. But I mean, he has all these people brainwashed that he can do whatever he wants. So.
But that's a big money fight.
Yeah.
You and him, it does. I think you each get $200 million. I think we have a fight.
I'll be straight with $5 million, $10 million.
No, let me put it on the record to pay you $200. What about?
I make that. That's what I'm saying, bro. Like I'm put in a position where I can't say too much. I can't ask for too much. And because of what, you know what I mean? Everything he says, he's saying all this stuff for reason. Like, he can do whatever he wants. He's a king. You know, fuck that, bro.
One fight he may have is Berlanga. Is that competitive?
Tell me, Ali, is that fucking fight competitive?
He's a big advantage. I don't know percentage-wise, but he's a huge favorite.
Yeah. I mean,
Berlanga does have a low pop.
I mean, I guess it could be a good fight. You know, Mexican, Puerto Rican, it's always a big fight, so I think that's the biggest value I've seen in that. But other than that, man, like, why don't you fight Berlanga with Caleb first and then get a little bit more buzz out of Berlanga before you go just give him the fight? Oh, and then he's now he's mandatory to fight that guy from the IBF.
Yeah, well I'm sorry to say I don't know the guy.
That doesn't mean he's not great. I'm not even being disrespectful either. I've never heard of that guy.
Yeah, but IBF, that's their rule and they're sticking by it.
Yeah.
Boxing is a crazy.
Well, at least somebody's sticking by their mandatories. At least there's a sanctioning body that actually mandates the mandatory. So that's refreshing to see in boxing.
Okay, so a couple days ago, you're minding your own business. You're in camp. You're not bothering nobody. You go online and your phone's blown up. Ryan Garcia's calling you out. How did you find out?
I don't know. I think somebody showed me. But for me, bro, I just trolled it. You know what I mean? I just trolled it. I knew he was trolling me. But I said, fuck it. I'm going to just ride the wave and get on this, see what happens. I mean,
you got a lot of followers out of it.
Yeah, I got like 5,000, something like that. That was cool. I mean, social media shit, bro, I'm not really into that shit, but it is what it is. I guess trolling, and I think it's funny for the fans.
He called out Earl Spence. Let's say they
fight. I would want to see that fight. That would be a good fight. The only thing is that I think Earl Spence is done with that weight, 147. I would love to see it. It would make a lot of money, so I feel like if Earl Spence can make that weight again, why the fuck not? Might as well take the fight. And it's not gonna be an easy fight for anybody, but I'd pay money to see it.
I know you've always been very supportive of Devin Haney.
Yeah.
What do you tell him right now? He's probably at the toughest moment of his life because the way he lost and other things came out.
No, I sent Devin Haney a message, you know, even after this fight. And then, like I said, I stand on by what I say. You know, it's gonna be hard, but Devin Haney, he's a talented fighter. He's one of the best in the world. I don't think anybody his age has a resume that he has. So that just speaks on its own. So he'll definitely be back. Just hopefully he doesn't take the loss a little bit too hard. But, you know, he's great fighters make great comebacks. So I'm always going to beat Devin Haney's. I'm going to beat Team Haney. You know, I love his dad. I love his brother. I love everybody on that side. So I'm always going to be supporting him. Win, lose, or draw.
Ellie Seckback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.